Well, hello. Welcome to Pau Island. I'm Lucky, and let's talk custom designs. Now, this is a beginner's tutorial for those of you that really don't understand your custom design app and would like a little inside scoop. So let's get right to it. It's in your pocket phone there. Pull it out, and you'll see custom designs is the little pencil and white top. Let's click on it. And when you first actually get into it, you will see that there are two rows, five apiece, of preset patterns that come with the program, come with the game. You can choose to change them later. I happen to actually like the little three leaf and the footprint pattern, and we'll see those in action in a moment. So everything else below those two rows, and there's a total of 50 spaces, 50. Okay, so 10 are already taken up with their stuff. So you have 40 spaces down below. And what these spaces look like when they're not full of stuff is exactly what I'm hovering over right now. It says design pattern, and it is a white background with a pink broken up little cross on it. So it's spaces between the little pink lines. So that's what you start with. So any of the patterns here can be changed, including the ones that come with the game. So eventually when you need more space, these will be options for you. So I imported a few from mine. We won't go there right now. I did play with a couple of them, and that's why they say empty. So once I actually get to one, it says design pattern. This one says design pattern. They're both the same, except I cleaned this one up and just made it a white background. Now, transparent, you can see the difference with the transparent ones. There's no background to them. They're transparent in the background, okay? So let's start by taking one of the actual design patterns that are brand new. You can wear your designs. If you display your designs, they'll be on an easel, like an art stand, and as if you're displaying art, or they can be displayed on the ground like I have done here. Now, these are a little bit different than things we have in our terraforming pavement. The terraforming pavement can only stay above the beach. It cannot come down on the beach, okay? And the other thing I should mention is all of this stuff that we make in this palette area can be kicked away. So be mindful of that when you're out and about. Sometimes we kick at things, and if you've missed something and you have a design close by, you can end up kicking your design away. So just something to think about, okay? The actual paving pieces from the terraforming, that doesn't happen with them. All right, let's jump right into it. So we're going to change the design on one of the very brand new basic ones. And what ends up happening is we have a toolbox, we have a palette arrangement, and we have some canvas area. We work on this piece. It's shown in true form here, and then visually we get to see it here. And the difference is this: if I now make the background, which now currently is white, into the transparent one, which is always on the last, it's the last piece on every palette. And I call these the jelly beans when they look like this, because they're a little bit different when they're in the selection mode. So on my row of jelly beans, the very last jelly bean is the transparent one. It always is. And the reason I can tell I'm in white right now, first of all, I'm not seeing it. I see the red pen. So whatever the little pen is in, I'm in pen mode right now in my tools. I'm in pen mode. The background always disappears. The minute you press X, all this shows up. But I'm in pen mode. I'm in the smallest. There's a small, medium, large, a 1 square, 2 by 2 square, 3 by 3 square. I'm in the red mode because the line is under here. So how do I know that this is white? Because it's showing up as white here. If it was transparent, and let's watch what I'm doing. This is now important here. Left and right of the Joy-Cons, the very top buttons, will, you know, scale you back and forth. Left and right simultaneously together. If you hover over any color on your palette, on your work spot, it'll show you which one it is up here. So let's just do that for a moment. Let's take the little button here, the little pen, and hover it over the pink and then press left and right. Did you see what happened? The line went from red to this pink, soft pink, and it changed here as well. So why is that helpful? If you have a lot of different colors at one time that are similar shades of grays or greens, and you want to, you know, repeat one somewhere, you can just hover over it right and left at the same time, and then you've got that color. So it's a handy thing. Now the rest of this is white. If I do left and right again, I'm now under the white and my pen is white. If I now go a little bit further over, I'm in transparent. Okay, and now this might seem interesting, but I want to fill this whole thing. But if I'm in pen mode right now and I press Y to the middle size and Y to the large, if I now actually go along and remove this, just this so you can see, watch what's happening up in that other area. I'm actually, in essence, erasing this manually. Okay, I now have a chunk of transparent space in here, and you can vaguely see the outline of it there. So I'm going to stay in the transparent mode, but I'm going to make this easy on myself. I'm going to press X. Now everything lights up in the toolbox. They're all available to me. I'm scrolling below the pen, not to fill, but to the bigger brother, fill all. I'm going to click on it because I've accepted it. Everything else fades away. Now we know I've got this in my hand. I'm using this. It's in the middle of the page because it's telling me everything's going to be full. And it's currently full of transparent. So if I hit accept or A, look what happens over here. Everything disappears. I'm now transparent. Okay? If I go with my upper horizontal toggle, and now I go to black and do the same thing, press A, I've got a black background. Let's go back to transparent. That takes care of big fill, fill all. If we happen to now go to our tools, let's just very quickly look at change palette and change color. If we click on this one, note why I call them jelly beans, because they kind of, or kidney beans, they look like little jelly beans to me. The very first row here is the row that's up here. This is the row they start all of these palettes with. That's it. Now, and so you have to automatically pick a row to be at the top. So can you see how as we scroll down, some of these palettes can be very similar in some of the shades and colors here, the fleshy tone ones and the grayscale. So if you were using, let's bring up the grayscale, and I want you to see something now. If I want to make a pavement thing with rocks, transparent to put over stuff. Okay, so I can actually see grass through it. I want rocks. But I want to still use a few blades of my own grass in there. But I have no green on this palette. You go to change color. Now in this instance, I won't do it yet because I'm underneath my transparent. I'm going to pick a jelly bean that I might not use very much. So I'm going to use my toggle up top, and I'm going to go across my left button, and I'm going to pick that jelly bean. So you can see that I'm under the middle jelly bean, and that's the one I'm going to change the color of. So again, right now, all of this is what that color is. The hue, the vividness, and the brightness make up this. But I would like some green. So my hue is going to go over a little bit more to the green department. But that jelly bean doesn't look green. But look at what happened to the vividness and the brightness below. As I move the vividness up, it changes the brightness below, as well as the vividness changes as well. So if I go now brightness and really want to go, I have some choices there. So let's just leave it here for sake of conversation, so it's a bit bright on the screen. Now I have, you know, a green in my palette of grays and black, okay? So that's how that plays out, because it's really handy when all of a sudden you really want more of a, you know, a monochromatic kind of look there, but you need one color in there. Okay, so that's that. So now we're going to look at the rest of our tools here. The line tool is actually quite a handy one when you want straightaways. Now, you can't see me using my Joy-Cons, but you can see right away there's a little square and I can't change the size. Okay, so the first placement is put it into the position wherever you want, and then you press your A button and it holds it. Now I'm going to use the green, and what we're going to do is see, I'm going to go right to the top corner, and now I press A, and it fastens it there. So it's like holding it, a holder. With the arrow buttons, or the toggle button is the one I'm using, I'm just going to run this line straight across. Now, I haven't pressed A yet. I can still toggle this whichever direction I want. If I only want to go halfway with this, only halfway. Now I accept it. That's when you can see that this shows up. Before this was there, that didn't show up. And we'll do that again, because now we're going to go from that spot, from that very same spot. Actually, we're going to go one over, and I'm going to go up. Okay. Note how nothing is down below yet. I'm still in work mode. I can still toggle this around and move it wherever I want. Oh, I've changed my mind. I just want to go down this way instead. Now I press A, boom. I only have one undo. I don't get to undo all of this. If I undo it now, it's only that one. And I can then redo it. After that, and I accept it, I move on. So now I'm gonna go to this spot here, and let's say on this one, I'm just gonna go straight. Okay, so I've made this kind of little thing here. So this line is great. It really helps you when you need straightaways. Now let's get into our junior fill, the one that only fills sections. Okay, and we're going to go ahead and just toggle over to a gray, fill that with that gray, toggle to another gray, fill this one with that gray, and then we're going to toggle this one with a really light gray. Okay, now, well, that looks almost really three-dimensional. It can look like it's going inward or outward, but that's what shadowing is all about, the dark on top and where the light's coming in. Okay, so that's cool. So we got ourselves a little pyramid. And the Phil Jr. fills sections, and he does not fill all, okay? So just remember that. Now, let's get to something that is just, in a nutshell, these other tools. And you're going to play with them yourself and have a little fun. And that is things like the circle tool and the rectangle. They're identical in usage. I'll use the rectangle for sake of conversation. On the board, you can see that I have a little arrow. This is going to be where things anchor, but this is a bit deceptive because it can actually go outside. So it's always going to be a couple spaces away from, like it starts from the inside of the spot. So if I go outside here, outside this, and let's go and do black. And you can see now that this rectangle, I can actually border this and make that as a border if I'd like. I can shorten it and just do a piece of it. You know what I'm saying? So this wherever I choose to put it, you have to factor in that this little piece, it starts in the point on the inside, okay? Now, again, I haven't accepted it. Nothing's down here. The minute I say A, one of the arrows disappears, and then you're going to start a second time. That's the same with the circle when you're building the circle one. So we just self-explanatory there. I suggest you just play with them. Now we want to go back to our toolbox. So we've done those two. The round stamp, the heart stamp, and the star stamp are exactly as they sound. We're going to take the heart stamp here. And we're going to go over this gray area down here. You can see the blue outline. You can have the size changes for the three stamps. You've got a small, a medium, and a large, and they rotate again in a forward motion. So if I press the Y, it's large, it's small, medium, large, and so on. So if we put it somewhere, here's what you have to understand about stamps. They're very much like little stamps that you dip into your ink and pound it down on your piece of paper. Whatever is on this little stamp pad, that's the black right now, that's what's going to fill this when I press A. Okay? That's how that works. Now, same with the star, same with the circle. Play with them, have some fun. Now let's get back into our toolbox, and we've pretty much managed all these up above, okay? We're now going to drag this design, And the way we're going to do that is just press the A, and you'll now see that there's a drag arrow. Now I can turn around and just, yeah, do whatever I want with this. I can line that up in the center, and I've got a completely, almost like a card style pattern here. So, you know, and to get it back into center, you know, you say to yourself, okay, well, where was I? What was the line like? There we go. We're back in. So that is your drag, and that's kind of a cool one that I used for that split face one, and I'll highlight that in just a moment. So here we are. We're going to say done, with, or not done, pardon me. We're going to just get back into our tools, press X. The last thing is the mirror. Now, the mirror doesn't have to come down here to press it, but I'm highlighting it down here so you can actually physically see it. When I press the A, look what happens on screen. I get a yellow and a blue, and it's going to mirror each other. And right now, there's one little dot in the center. But I don't have to physically go into my tools to get here. I can do this one by pressing the ZR, so the top back button on the right side. The right-hand switch, the very top back button is the one you're going to press for coming and going from this. Okay, so if I do the heart shape, for example, I'm going to press on that, and I got out of my duplication mode. So, you know, here you can see if I can just go right over this one again and have that one right next to it. Do them up here. Let's do them in small mode. That's why they're too big. Why there? Okay, see these two little hearts up here? Boom, done. Okay, so that shows you the mirroring effect. And if I want to exit the mirroring effect to do some more work on this, I would now just press the ZR again, and I'm out of there. Okay, and now I'm just going to be doing one item by itself. So can we undo that? We sure can. We didn't want that there. Perfect. So now we only have one last thing, and that is this little guy here, which is your swap, the preview. And this one is just, you know, press the A button, and now you can see when you're in there, and you can rotate this on the bottom of the A with the little toggle button, and you can see what it would look like as a garment. So there's that, as well as the mask, so you can see what this would look like as a face mask, okay? And then the pavement on the ground, as well as the artwork. All right, that is your tools and how to use them. I hope that was pretty okay for you to understand. I tried to keep it basic. I'm sorry the time's run up. There'll be this is all I will do for this. We'll have some fun with playing with some designs in another one when you know the tools, and I can just go ahead and have some fun and play with them. So let's just now exit, done, the plus sign. I'll just confirm just to keep that one so we can look at it on the ground. Okay, so there's your pattern. And I can just go ahead and select that one, and I can display it on the ground, and there it is. Now, just wanted to talk about this one very quick. We're just going to go in and explain how I got this out of this. You know, that just, they just seem like two different designs, and this one looks so much bigger than this one, but I started with this and ended with that. And how is that possible? And that's simply possible because I went into my tools and I was actually demonstrating the drag. And if you look at the drag button now, there it is. It's that's what I had originally, okay? And that's what's on the ground originally. And while I'm here, is that a blue dot that I see there? Do you see that, or is it just my imagination? Pen. I have a feeling blue. How did you get to be there? Black, okay. There we go. Now I'm good. But so with this one, I just got in the tools and I was just demoing that if you, you know, change it up a little bit. And when I went down here, it was like, you gotta be kidding me. This was like almost too spooky. I thought, wow, all I did for it, when I saw it like this, is put the two white eyes in, and I thought, yeah, way to go. Now, see, I'm going to cancel. Oh no, I want to actually keep editing because I liked what I just did with the black dot. So I want to save that. So now I'll just go ahead and say done, and done, and we're done. and that's good to go. So that's what it looks like, and it was kind of a fun little thing to try. So have some fun, play with these. It's not complex. It just takes a minute to figure out what the tools do and how they work. And just enjoy it, you guys. Have some fun with this. Let's not make this too complicated. It should be really enjoyable. So there you go. Have some fun with it. Make some fireworks, by the way. Start with a burst in the scent, something that'll burst, a star or a circle, and then little lines shooting out of it. You'd be surprised how nice that'll look in the night sky. Okay, joy and happiness. Feeling the love. Because Diana gave me the heart the other day. How exciting is that? So I'm sending out some joy and happiness your way. Lots of hugs. And thanks for subscribing, for liking, for hanging out with me. And you know, here on my channel, oops-a-daisy, dropped one of my Joy-Cons. But thank God the right one still exists. On my channel, I answer the questions. You will never find yourself asking a question and then there isn't an answer. I find that's probably the one thing on YouTube that disturbs me the most about creators is when they put out an educational video or something to teach you something and you clearly have a viable question because you see everybody else is asking the same question and they don't come back and check it out. So please know I do. I read your comments. I really do, and they mean a lot to me. And if I can help you guys, that is my goal. All right? Take care, everybody. Bye-bye.